Trees in pixel art are super easy to create. You just draw a trunk, draw some leaves on top, add some lighting, and you're done. Okay, probably you would like a few more details than that. It is true that for creating pixel art trees, starting with a trunk is a good first step. For pixel art bushes, we can get away without a trunk and start more simple. It might still be useful in some cases to also start with a trunk when you create a bush, but more on that later in the video. So let's create a bush. All we need is one main color in our palette. The obvious choice would be some green tone. Of course, you are free to choose a different color depending on the setting and mood of your pixel art scene, but let's pick this green for now. We also need a couple of shades and tints for our main color, so let's add two darker and two lighter variants. Now, the fastest way for beginners to create a nice looking bush in pixel art is to use a custom brush. Think of that brush as a small portion of the bush, which we can use to create the entire bush. To create that brush, we choose our second darkest green color and simply draw a few leaves like this. You might want to do that on a separate layer in case you later need to select those leaves again. We then select those leaves and create a brush from it. In Aseprite, you can do that by pressing Ctrl plus B on your keyboard, or select it from the menu, like this. As you can see, we now have this little leaf structure as our cursor, and we can start creating a bush like this. We start clicking with our brush and create the general shape of the bush type that we are aiming for. Make sure to not click and drag, but instead create the bush with individual clicks of our brush, until you are happy with the overall shape. This way, the individual leaves stay more visible compared to just dragging the brush over the canvas. Then we move one green tone up in our palette to the main color and repeat the same process. Make sure to sufficiently paint over the existing shape, but use fewer clicks than before, so that we still see enough of the darker parts underneath. So now we have an object on screen that is already quite recognizable as a bush. But we still need to add some lighting. And for that, we are going to use all the remaining green tones in our palette. First, we need to decide a direction from which the light is shining on our bush. Make sure that this light direction is consistent with any other objects you might already have in your pixel art scene. Otherwise, it looks weird. Now, we pick the slightly lighter tint of our main color, and we add a few clicks with our brush on the side of the bush that is hit by light. And now comes the fun part. We now select all the green tones in our palette from dark to light by clicking and dragging in the palette window. Then we cancel our custom brush selection and use the standard round brush again. With that round brush, we switch from simple ink mode to shading mode like this. When we now hover above our brush, we see that we are now able to add shades to the object. We can also adjust our brush size depending on how broad you want the shading to be. In this case, let's go for a slightly smaller size so that we see all the nice little details of our bush in the end. And now we add shading to the side of the bush that is not hit by light. We can also add some smaller, darker areas on the other side of the bush to give it a more natural and interesting look. And once that is done, we click reverse shading, like this. And now we can add highlighting instead of shading to our bush. So let's do that and add highlights to the side of the bush that is hit by light. And again, we can do also some smaller areas also on the other side to give it a more natural look. And here we go. This is how you can create some awesome pixel art bushes in no time. So, what about trees then? For trees, we should start with a trunk. And for that, we need to create another main color in our palette. We will go with some brown tone for now, but again, feel free to pick whatever you like. Just like we did for our green tones, we also add two darker and two lighter variants of that main color. Now, starting with the second darkest brown tone, we now create our trunk. Here, we basically have endless possibilities, as real trees in nature can have all kinds of shapes. And it is always good to look at some reference images to get some inspiration. A general principle here is to let the trunk start thick at the bottom and then let it branch out into thinner branches and twigs like this. Make sure to create something slightly chaotic, without a clearly visible pattern or symmetric structure, because this is how Mother Nature does it too. Once we are happy with our trunk, we can go one tone up in our palette to the main brown color. With that color, we now create all the parts of the trunk that are hit by light. This gives us a general shading structure for the trunk. Next, we select all brown tones in our palette from dark to light, and then switch from simple ink to shading mode. Just like we did for the bush, we can now create shading to the parts of the trunk that are facing away from the light. We then click reverse shading and add highlights to the parts of the trunk that are hit by light. And this gives us a nice looking tree trunk with only a few simple steps. So let's add some leaves now. To create the leaves, we can use the same method that we already used for creating the bush. So we start by creating a custom brush like this. Again, we create the indication of a few tree leaves and use that as our building block to create the entire leaf structure. You might again want to create those leaves on a separate layer to not mess too much with the trunk, in case you want to change the trunk later. With our new brush and the second darkest green tone selected, we now create the first layer of leaves. Again, make sure to do that with individual clicks, rather than just clicking and dragging the brush over the canvas. We then repeat the same techniques with the main green color, and once more with one color tone up in our palette, but only on the side of the tree that is facing the light. Next, we select all green tones in our palette, we make sure to use the standard round brush again, and we switch from simple color to shading mode. With some shading on the parts that are not facing the light, then pressing reverse shading and adding some highlights on the parts that are facing the light, we have created our pixel art tree. In the beginning of the video, I mentioned that sometimes when you want to create a pixel art bush, it might still be useful to start with a trunk first. So when is this the case? Well, it is always good to do that when the bush is not as dense as the one I created just now, and when it actually has more of a small tree structure itself. So now it is time to put those trees and bushes into your game or your pixel art scene, and if you would like to know 5 simple steps to create pixel art scenes much more easily, you can check out this video next.